y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be reviewing a new fragrance that I just picked up, and that fragrance is the K. Ollie Yum Pistachio Gelato M Intense. So this is what the packaging looks like. It's like a very light sage pastel, like spring vibe boxing, and then they also put the exact same frosted color on to the fragrance, which I actually really like because most of their bottles are either clear or red, and they do have a black one, but most of them are like clear. You can see the fragrance in them kinda, but I do like this. I think it presents like a very fresh packaging for K. Ollie, and so let's talk about all of the scents that are in it. So the scents are pistachio gelato, hazelnut, sweet rum, whipped cream, marshmallow, and cotton candy. So first impression is it does have the sweetness to it. And then I'm gonna go ahead and spray it on. And just from like that quick spray, I already pick up on the sweet rum and the whipped cream kind of scent. And I kind of feel like it's supposed to be a, let's see what fragrance family it's in. So for the fragrance family, it's supposed to be warm and spicy, and then the scent type is warm and sweet gourmands. And then on the Sephora site, it says the main three notes are the pistachio gelato, cotton candy, and whipped cream. But for me, I picked up on the whipped cream and the marshmallow more than anything. I think kind of like as it dries down, the sweet rum starts to stick out a little bit, and then it kind of finishes up with the pistachio gelato. So about the fragrance, she says, "Ever since I can remember, ice cream has been my favorite food, and then I went to Rome in 2014 with my sister, Elia, and discovered pistachio gelato, and I was obsessed. And it inspired me to combine my two favorite indulgences, fragrance and gelato. I wanted to create something that made me feel yummy, happy, and irresistible. With every delicious spritz, you'll feel like you are the dessert." So that's what Mona had to say about the fragrance. And so for the bottle, in which I have a couple of these, but I haven't ever really like looked into why or what the bottle was like that for. But it says here that the signature diamond shaped bottle is Alchemy and Jewel Caps, is inspired by traditional Middle Eastern oud bottles. This time feature as a playful pastel green frosted glass topped with a matte white jewel cap for yummy pistachio gelato 33 EDP, which means all day perfume. Intense, and the number 33 indicates the 33 rounds of formulations it took to achieve the perfect balance of warm wrapped in sweetness. So I don't know, it's dried down and it's still giving sweet to me. Like, it is still giving me very much a sweet fragrance. Like, I don't really get the warm and spicy. It does give like warm, but it gives like more so, I don't know, I just get sweet the most for me. But it is the warm and sweet gourmand, but the fragrance family is warm and spicy. So yeah, I get sweet more than anything, and to me, I feel like it's a very clean, like a very clean presenting fragrance. Like, it's not really taking a lot to make it smell the way it smells. They're not having to like put 33 different, well, they did put 33 different fragrances together, what do I mean, but like they didn't have to like make it complicated. It's very simple, it's very clean, it's very warm and sweet. So I would say this is more, the bottle itself reads fragrance of springtime, and I kind of think that this is one you might be able to pull off year round. I would wear it in the spring, and I would definitely wear it, I would still wear it in the summer. Because like I said, to me, it presents clean. Like, I like, it's just a plain, clean, natural smelling fragrance. Like, there's nothing really crazy. And I think that the scents that she chose are paired together very well. Like, all six of these, she did her big one with this one. And I really enjoyed it. Honestly, I did get the 1.7 fluid ounce bottle. This one retails for $100. This is the only one that they had in the store. Well, actually, they had a 3.4, but my friend got the 3.4. So I was like, I can just get the 1.7 because I have a really big fragrance collection. So I was like, I don't have to have the biggest bottle of everything. Now, I will say some bottles I will not get this, like, I have to have the big fragrance because I like the way that they're shaped. Like the Carolina Herreras, big high heel only. Big high heel only. I don't know why, but I gotta have big high heel every single time. Like every single time, it's gotta be big high heel. So, but yeah, these are kind of all the same. And this one I can like throw in my bag and have on me because I really like the K. Alley fragrances, and I think that some of them do kind of stay with me, but some of them be needing a little touch-up spray because like I want to enter the room and get va-va-voom, you know, like I want people to know I'm in here. Now, as I'm wearing the fragrance, I've already sprayed it and it's dried down, but I can still smell it. So I think that this one might be one of the ones that sticks with you throughout the day, and I like that. Now, because like one of my favorite fragrances by them is the Candy Apple, the Eden, well, actually not Candy Apple, it's the Eden Juicy Apple. That's like my number one favorite fragrance for them. Now I did do a review over there, and it is up on my channel already. I will probably link it at the end of this video, but anyways, that's like one of my top fragrances of K. Alley, and I have a couple different ones by them, but that's my personal favorite. I do like, I'm more of a fruity floral girl. Like I love the sweet fragrances. I think sweet fragrances just they just give me yummy, like chew me up, spit me out, you know. So that's why I typically gravitate towards those. Now, do I think that this will be one of my new favorites? Absolutely. I can definitely honestly say this will be one of my fragrances. And I actually kind of wonder what this one will smell like with, if I was to pair it with the vanilla. Like, I might do a little play around with that and see what that would be like, the K. Alley vanilla with this. I don't know. Let's read the fragrances that they have in that one. So in this one, so yeah, this one is Warm and Sweet Gourmand as well, and it has Vanilla Orchard, Tonka, Absolute, and Amber Woods. So I would say that I think they would pair well together, and I'm gonna try it and I will see how I feel. That was a good idea. Proud of me. So I know that for this particular fragrance, it was compared to Prada Candy, and I just was not getting it at all. I'm going to see what fragrances are in the Prada Candy. Well, scents. So for the Prada Candy, the scents, it's a warm and sweet as well, but it has white musk, benzoin, and caramel accord. And for me, I don't know. It's just not reading to me that they are the same, because musk, benzoin, and caramel is definitely nothing like pistachio, gelato, hazelnut, sweet cream, whipped cream, marshmallow, and cotton candy. Maybe the sweet cream and the whipped cream together is maybe where they're pulling out the caramelly vibe, or maybe it's the hazelnut. But I just think that hazelnut and caramel are just two different distinctive scents. So nah, I'm not agreeing with that. But you know, I will link this product below. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more fragrance reviews from me, and I will see you guys in my next video.